It's a white. Where's Matthew?
Two of us will get in there, one will stand there.
Matt, stand up in front. Matt, go in front. Over. That's it. Give us a wave.
Handed over 2.25 million garments why Walt Disney World has the world's largest working wardrobe. Folks, everybody needs to remain fully seated at all times, please, and keep your heads and arms inside the car. Just beyond that, you're going to notice our light, prop, and camera department. This is where we store and maintain equipment until it's ready to be used, either on or off our lot. And off the network TV crews, we use our equipment when covering the shuttle launches out of the Kennedy Space Center. Just beyond that is our scenic shop. This is where carpenters work hard on sets that start here but end up on a soundstage. Now, what they often build in there is called a standing set, unless of course it falls, but a standing set is one that can get used over and over again. It can be as simple as a bedroom or as elaborate as an entire house. And up on
too much, that can keep it straight.
that's right.
Matthew, get with him.
Come up with Grandma then. Matthew's gonna get his.
Matt, give him a shake, Dan.
Matthew, have you had it signed?
Yeah.
Okay. Wait. There it is.
Matthew, have a cuddle. Matt, go and have a... Go and hold him, Matt. Yeah, go and hold him. Give him a cuddle, Mum. Dan, give him a cuddle. Don't. Matthew! Woo! And the swimming pool then. Thank you. Go on, Matt. This is the apartment at Resort World. Say hello, Jim and Matthew.
Hello.
Hello.
This is the kitchen with a rather small fridge cum freezer which makes ice.
Should have had a washing machine
stuck
outside
in the street.
One of the bedrooms. It's a little bit small, but never mind.
With a rather small bed. Lie on the bed, Matt. Shall
I? What's Denise doing here?
Go on, lie on the bed, right on it.
It's just a small king size bed.
What?
I got it.
Oh, it's smooth. Why do you keep doing that, Dad?
Still doing it.
No.
Yes.
And then you can take
that
it
for
out.
Me, Andrew, mate. Now we're walking into the bed bathroom. Jacuzzi, whirlpool, bath. Just one or two. Poses, are we? Just two small beds.
Okay, like any word beginning with R on me, and I'll show you some magic stuff.
Okay, rabbit.
Rabbit. Keep it coming.
Rocking. Rock.
Not bad.
Going into the bathroom. Bathroom. Yeah, bathroom. Matthew. Thank you. One on.
Can I put a big one on?
I'm going to go to the side.
Can you do a belly dance? Matthew, give us a smile. Matthew, jump in the water.
No, that's it. Switch that boat.
Mom. Dad. Dad. Where's
He's gone in the shop over there.
Animals. But alligators can have up to 82 very sharp teeth, and in their jaws, they can the state of Florida. Last year we did have one fatal attack. It was very unfortunate. It was a four-year-old girl. She was attacked and killed by an 11-foot wild alligator. So that attack just goes to show you that alligators, although normally not aggressive against human beings, are very dangerous. They're also very unpredictable. So while you're here visiting the state of Florida, if you do happen to run across an alligator, the best advice that I can give you, just leave the animal alone. Please don't attempt to approach any alligators that you may run across on land. That can be very dangerous. Also, please don't attempt to feed any alligators that you may run across also. Here in the state of Florida, anyone who is caught feeding a wild alligator is breaking the law. It's a $500 fine. It's also up to 60 days in jail. Now, the reason we have that law is because whenever you feed one of these animals, they tend to associate that food with human beings. They tend to lose that natural fear of man. And once that happens, they do become very aggressive against humans and very dangerous. So while you're here visiting the state of Florida, if you would like to feed an alligator here, Gatorland Zoo would be a good place to do that. We don't have any wild alligators. It's not illegal to feed these animals. But if you are going to feed them, what I'd like you to do, just take your food, pick out the alligator that you want to feed, toss the food right down to the side of his head, just like that. That brings very good results. Please don't lean over the rails. Please don't hang your fish out there and attempt to get the alligators to jump. We don't want to ruin any of your vacation. I'd really like it if everyone here today would leave with everything that you walked in with. So please be very, very careful. And that does include your children. If you do have children, don't allow them to climb or to stand directly on top of the railing. Now in the show area, smaller children are allowed to sit on the top rail, but that's the only place in the park that we allow that. Believe me, folks, if anyone was ever to go into the water at Gatorland, it would be absolutely no different than this meat that I'm throwing in. These alligators would consider that to be food. They would attempt to eat it. Alligators consider anything that hits the water here something they can't eat, so please be very careful. Now, for that very reason, you may have noticed that around my waist here, I've got on a large leather belt. Here in the back, I've got it attached to a heavy-duty chain. Now, that's a restraining device for me in case I was ever to lean over too far. Perhaps an alligator was to reach up and grab hold of my hand. This device would hopefully ensure that the rest of my body did not get pulled into this water with all these alligators. But we're not going to dwell on that any longer today. What we're going to go ahead and do are try and get some jumps out of these alligators. Now, what I'll be doing, putting out the chickens on the cable. If you have your cameras, you may want to go ahead and make sure they're ready to go. Once I get these chickens out, there's absolutely no telling what to expect from these alligators. All right, guys. Let's time. Get it. All right, everyone looks real excited. All right, they're starting to move. Now, in case you're wondering how these alligators jump, what they normally do, they put their tails down on the bottom, and then they push off. All right, there's a nice jump right there. We got one off over here. Only two more pieces of meat left. And there goes the crocodile. All right, not long at all did it take for these alligators to clear those tables. They did a real good job. But we do have some more jumping to do for you. If you'd like to see some more alligators jump, I have brought along a few more pieces of meat. I am going to be getting these alligators around the platform to jump. I've also got with me today a nice fat whole chicken. Now what I'm going to do with this whole chicken, I'm going to save it for the last jump of the show. At that time, I'm going to try to get an alligator to take this chicken here right out of my hand. So we're going to save that jump for a little later on. Right now, we're going to go ahead and get a few of these alligators. Now right over here, we've got an animal that is not exactly an alligator, because it's not an alligator, it is a crocodile. And this crocodile really knows how to jump, so I'm going to try to bring him up here and get him to jump for us. You may want to get your cameras ready to take a picture of this. He's a real good jumper. He just went underwater. So we can't get him to jump until he comes back up. Let's go ahead and try to get another alligator to jump for us. We'll come right over here. He's a volunteer. Get him. Go. All right, that gator sort of jerks around when he's up. Throwing the crocodile's back. Let's go over here and try to get the croc. Croc! Croc! All right, the crocodile's taking too long. We got too many alligators. All right, gator. First come, first serve. Somebody. All right, and we got a lot of gators right in the room there, but too bad I only have one piece of meat. Well, I only have to get one out there, so let's go ahead. I got about four pieces of meat left. We're going to go ahead and try to get some jumps all the way around. bad jump. A nice catch at that. One more right here in front. You want to jump again since you're here? All right. Go. Ooh. All right, another real nice jump. And that does bring me down to my one more piece of meat here. And that is the whole chicken. And like I said, what we're going to try and do here is get an alligator to take this chicken out of my hand. But if you are directly behind me, you may want to move out a little bit to either side. You'll get a much better view of the jump. It is going to be right in front. So if you'd like to move around a little bit, I give you plenty of time to do that so you get a better view. While they're moving, I would like to thank all of you for coming out watching the show today. After the show, if you have any questions about alligators, I'll be glad to answer any questions that I can. We also do have an alligator education center. It's that building right over there with the yellow sign on it right behind the snack bar. Lots of interesting facts in that building about alligators. All right, guys, we got a whole chicken. Whole chicken. Hey! They're breaking all kinds of speed records. Just to get up here. Yikes! Whole chicken here. All right, we got this hitter here turned around. Let's see if we can't get him up here to jump. Hey! You gonna jump for me? Right here. Get up. You ready? Go, Gator. Go. There we go. Nice jump. Takes the chicken right out of the hand. We're going to say that's it, folks. Thank you very much. Have a very nice day.